With the Lauren Boebert allegations coming out, Ted Cruz has been a pretty big source of conversation. Why is he so weirdly tied with Lauren Boebert, and was very early on? There's no reason to believe he would have known her based on her shooter's grill before she became the nominee, but he has been close to her, tweeting out photos like this about her drill baby drill at the State of the Union and stuff like that. He's traveled with her back in 2020. He was traveling with her. This is before she was ever elected to office. Bear in mind, she's not a representative, or was a candidate from his state. They're totally different states, totally different places. Now, it's not impossible that you could campaign for someone outside. Like Bernie Sanders will go and he'll campaign with Jessica Cisneros. So that's possible. But the issue is that there are part of the allegations about the escort thing is that she was introduced to Ted Cruz. And so, you know, the mind starts to whirl. All of these are allegations. Nothing has been proven. But what apparently is true is that Boebert got $136,250 from Ted Cruz for her campaign back in 2019. She also failed to disclose a $70,500 donation noted in Cruz's Federal Election Commission's filing. So that's a lot of money that Ted Cruz is sending to a never elected, you know, candidate in a different state. Again, it's not impossible that that could be legitimate, but you know, people are speculating about theory. If we believe these allegations, then is it inconceivable that she has information about him or whatever? All of this is getting into what I consider the area of politics that I hate, because it's pure speculation. It feels dirty to even speculate, but there is some weird behavior that we have to try to understand.
Yeah, that's the thing. All these guys have probably some form of level of skeletons in their closet, things that they've done, would do, have paid, been paid for. And this is where it's hard. If you then dive into all of that and go to discover it, man, we'll spend months. Look, it's been a year just on January 6th, and that's a huge event that actually does encompass a lot of politicians and a lot of pundits and people that were probably involved and wanted to see that happen and go down the way that it did. And that's taken a year. And then look how many people actually are trying to push back and say the reality isn't what it is. So when it comes to uncovering things or looking into Ted Cruz's potential background with Lauren Boebert and what he knew and why he supported her and maybe dirt, man, it all kind of makes sense. But then again, after you go through just 5 minutes of thinking about it, you may go, ugh, but this is what sucks. They make us not want to have to go through all this. But look, they're horrible people that are changing and affecting people's lives, when really what they're trying to do is protect themselves, gain more power and money. And then that's the exchange we have to go with. So it's we find ourselves in this tough position of, should we continue to look at this, or should we continue to talk about this, when in reality, that would take forever to actually get to the end of.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. And like, so my mind instantly starts to try to come up with other explanations. So it could be, okay, Ted Cruz is a guy who's a senator, you know, so he's influential in the Republican Party, but everybody hates him. So maybe he just desperately needs up and coming figures in the party to like him. So, you know, go around and find those people that you think are going to be the next big thing and campaign with them when they could, you, but like maybe, you know, they're as turned off by being around Ted Cruz as anyone else, but they need the boost and they need the money, certainly. So attach yourself to the new blood, and it doesn't have to have anything to do with, you know, escorts or pregnancies or anything like that. That's possible, certainly. Ted Cruz is an overall skeezy guy, but what direction does the skeez go in? I don't know.
Skeez, we need a skeez meter.
Exactly. Does the skis head towards Cancun? Does it head towards the Coke thing? I don't know. I would love to find out, because let's speculate for a moment. All of this is true and is proven to be true. Let's say that we get evidence and it's all true. The only illegal part is the unlicensed thing. I'm not a lawyer, but I don't think that that would be a significant problem for her. So now let's grapple first with Boebert, then with Ted Cruz, because we're on Ted Cruz right now. If this is proven, how much does it matter? This is potentially, I think this is a bigger deal conceivably than the Madison Cawthorn stuff. But the Republican Party likes her a lot more than they liked Madison Cawthorn. So let's say it's proven to be true, maybe even before her primary, which is coming up. JR, what happens to Lauren Boebert?
This is the thing, so far, maybe there's a couple other exceptions as well. Donald Trump appears to be the only guy who can have these types of things openly and explicitly exposed about him. And he still goes on to keep his support and maybe even gain some because people are thinking, oh yeah, I totally want to back that guy. Locker room talk. I mean, everyone thought that was the takedown. So it depends on the level of political strength she has within the party. As you mentioned, Madison Cawthorn apparently had none of that. So whether or not there's enough people that will circle the wagons, make enough excuses for her, put their face and voice behind interviews and comments and statements to reporters about this and in her favor, maybe, but that would cause the, that would maybe take away some of their clout, or at least maybe some of their political power. Expend some of that for her. Maybe, I don't know if she's having much of a challenge, especially if there's nobody there in this particular district that doesn't do much as far as challenging her. They'll think it's okay. We have enough idiots in this district. They'll vote for her anyway.
Yeah, maybe. And again, first of all, like very few Republicans, I think, actually care about this stuff the way that they do opportunistically. Like if it was a Democrat, they'll pretend to care about it or whatever. Maybe there's some super hardcore evangelicals or whatever that do, but they didn't care about it for Trump, so they don't necessarily have to care about it for her. The stuff with Madison Cawthorn, which all so much of it was just like implication. The only reason that they are likely to care is because the idea was that, oh God, he's part of the LGBTQ community or something like that. If it was just photos of him draped across young women or something, I don't think that he would have been driven out of office. So yeah. I don't know. Now for Ted Cruz, they don't like Ted Cruz. So could this be used by the Republican Party to get a primary contender against him next time around? I think that there would be a lot of Republicans who would be perfectly happy with that. Like, imagine if this takes down Ted Cruz, but not Lauren Boebert. What a weird country we live in. But it's possible. It's possible.
Yep. Gotta have friends.
Okay. Let's dive into. I want to make sure that people understand that this is not the only thing going on. So Lauren Boebert is facing these allegations of being an unlicensed escort and the multiple abortions and all that. Which, as we've said, as progressives, like we don't have a problem with either of that. I think escort, there's nothing wrong with that whatsoever, and you should be able to get abortions. And in Colorado right now, you can. Unfortunately, thanks to people like Representative Lauren Boebert, maybe not for long. So that's really the issue with the abortion thing, is the hypocrisy. Like, she is alleged to have had two, one at Planned Parenthood. In 2021, she pushed a bill to block all funding to Planned Parenthood, as well as other health centers providing abortions. That same year, she told Planned Parenthood to go fund yourself. And she prides herself in supporting overturning Roe v. Wade and restoring the sanctity of life to the law. Now, maybe all of this is totally consistent. Maybe the allegations are untrue. And she actually thinks that women deserve no rights, or you know, people who can get pregnant should deserve no rights. That's possible. Plenty of Republicans are actually authentically horrible. She tweeted, "Planned Parenthood is not healthcare. It's a blood-stained money-making machine that prioritizes abortion over care." It is possible, but I understand we're gonna focus on this scandal. It's so big and all that. It's seemingly perfectly designed to draw attention. But I also wanna make sure that people understand that it's not like Lauren Boebert was scandal free before this. Like, there are claims that she paid for restaurant rent and her taxes with donor money, and that she threatened her employees that if they protested about not being paid the money she allegedly owed them, she threatened them over that. Back just a week ago, the New York Times reported that Colorado officials are examining allegations that she inflated the mileage she logged on the campaign trail back in 2020 and used more than $20,000 in reimbursements from donors to pay off tax liens on a restaurant. She alleged to have driven like tens of thousands of miles or something crazy like that with no campaign events. So that doesn't make any sense. She's been accused recently of covering up a serious injury causing accident days before a primary where she bailed out after her sister-in-law and son got injured because she drove an ATV into a rock face, and the ex-employees are saying that she refused to pay them while splurging on things. Some of this is like weirdly shamey and I don't like, but a lot of employees have had a problem with her. There have been some employees that have come out and said that she was a good boss or whatever, but plenty have complained that they were paid in cash out of the register or from Boebert's wallet without any taxes deducted, which is, that's illegal. You can't do that. And so a lot say that she was mostly checked out on the restaurant until she started drawing some press to it with her campaign so she'd come in for the filming. That's all just bad boss stuff. There are plenty of bad bosses to go around, but there are a lot of scandals. It's feeling a bit like Madison Cawthorn, JR.
This is the thing. There's always a question I've had. What is it that draws people to become politicians? And I'm sure there's multiple answers to that, but for the ones that end up being corrupt, who have it end up having a bunch of scandals in their closet and that don't want anyone to ever find out about. Maybe a lot of times it's to get a little bit of a respite from it, thinking they can now be above the law. They've created enough of a name and power structure for themselves that if anyone touches Lauren Boebert, if she's been in Congress, you know, for 4 or 5 terms, then that becomes like her standard and she can escape or skate from her previous potential crimes, right? I mean, it worked out for Donald Trump. All these folks, they follow that blueprint. We saw it when he even said he's complaining about his election loss. What do we start seeing? Everybody that's running for any kind of election that's a Republican that has the potential to lose, oh my God, election fraud, election fraud, election fraud. In this case, if she has all the stuff in her background, which it seems that she does, at least when it comes to her businesses and her practices around financial processes with her businesses, maybe this is her approach. She's like, oh, great. Hey, Ted, I'm gonna get into politics and maybe I can run away from all this stuff.
Yeah.
Maybe it's as simple as that.
Maybe. Anyway, look, my bigger issue with her is less about the scandals. I mean, that's part of it. It's like this is not what the solution to our problems as a society is, to just take people and just okay, we're gonna have primary elections. We're just gonna choose the person who says the most awful stuff. We're gonna do impurity tests, basically find the most messed up, horrible person. Doesn't have to have any experience whatsoever. Lauren Boebert didn't know a damn thing about politics and she hasn't learned anything since she ran, but she was awful, very enthusiastically, vocally awful. And so then we choose her. That is a big issue for America, I believe.
That's the new standard for running for office, yep.
Yeah, 100%. Like we don't need more of this. And God only knows now, like who decides to run for office now that they've seen, oh, it's Boebert's and it's Cawthorn's and it's Green's. That's what politics is, and it works. You can get in. Like there's no version of that where just being vocally progressive just gets you a position or whatever. There's no version on the left. On the right, just being horrible you don't have to have worked your way up through the system or whatever, be knowledgeable or anything like that. Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.